Well, today I'm going to demonstrate how to do silk screen. I made this silk screen for Joe Lawrence, and I'm going to print it real quick. I don't want to just, I want to stay focused. I may be doing this a little faster than I would normally do, but so what I'm doing is putting paper down between the back side of the shirt and the, and this is just a t-shirt that I have, and there's the neck. This would be the bottom. This is the silk screen. I kind of arrange it where I want it. Make sure that it's no wrinkles underneath there. So this is laying on top of the shirt now. I've got a poster board here and an old picture that I kind of use for, needs a little bit of give. And this is the fabric ink that I bought, and I just have this spatula here. And I put the ink at the top. Try not to move the silk screen. I mean, there are very involved ways of doing this. You can clamp this down so that you don't mistakenly move it. But since I'm here by myself and I'm concentrating, I think I have the ability to do this without holding it down, clamping it down. And I'm just pulling the ink down over the image. As you can see, I really didn't put enough ink on it. It's hard to know how much to put on really at first, but you can always, right in here is where there's not ink, but I'm putting it above at the top, and then I'm going to drag it that down. And you don't press down too hard, and just kind of gently do it. So the screen didn't move while I was printing it. It's always a good thing to have a place to put your things when you're done. Okay, I'll pull this off and see what it looks like. So it looks good.
Travelers, there's Karen, Earl, hey Earl, Fred Dieter, crazy neighbor.
Anger. I'm going to carefully.
Robert, thank you, is here.
Take you that out.
The Bushy boy.
Now you. This is still wet, so you really don't want to fold it over on itself. Since I'm just here by myself and no kids or anything. I'm just going to lay this down here on the floor. And the cat's outside, too. The cat can be a problem. Let's see. I bought some rock. Here. I'll do one more t-shirt.
Man, you're pretty sneaky with the little...
I actually had this t-shirt on earlier today.
I'm getting it.
But it's not...
Dad jokes with Carl the Unicorn.
Filthy dirty or anything. The thing is spreading, making sure that the wrinkles are out. I'll put this in here. but it's done the same way. I'm going to do this fast because there's a couple of other things that I want to print besides on t-shirts. But when you get in a hurry, sometimes you know how it is. It's kind of important to line it up with the neck to get the image where I want it. I think that's okay for now. There is a wrinkle right here, but I don't think that will matter. I mean, I'm just doing this. So I pressed it down, and once I pressed it down, I didn't move it. I won't have to put as much ink on this, I don't believe, to print it, because there's ink already on it. But I think I'm going to put more on it, because it's hard to really know if it's being printed all the way or not. There might be wrinkles in this. I do this very fast. So we'll see. That doesn't look like it's going through, but maybe it doesn't have to. Okay, so this was a quickie. Wait. So it didn't, there is, see this, that's what I was thinking right in here, where the ink didn't get to the, through the screen. But I can take some of the black ink. I'll do it right now just to show you. And a paintbrush. So I just take some of that ink. I could do this afterwards, so we wouldn't have to be watching this right now, really. But yeah, I was in a hurry, and I should have put more ink down. But that's really the only place where... I've got some experimental stuff to do too. I just kind of wanted to do this by myself. I've got, this is shelf liner, but I'm going to print on this. Now that plastic is kind of slick, what I'm printing on, so I have to be extra careful. Yeah, I don't want to bump this frame in any way, so it. But I'm putting more ink on this. I mean, I really haven't done silkscreen too many times, and it was a long time ago when I was in college. I don't think I have to press too hard. I'm usually the guy that, you know, presses twice as hard on anything or does that. I think this is done. I'll do it one more time. Now this is on plastic. I mean, I don't know how this is gonna turn out. Oh, it turned out nice. Well, not bad. I mean, it is actually handmade by me, not by a computer. It looks really kind of nice. I don't know if you can see the effect of it or not. And another thing I've got, I had no sheet, so I thought, there's black ink on there. You have to be careful with your fingers, so. But in a way, that, in one way, that's kind of part of it. Now this, I'm just kind of lay it there. Put more ink on it. And hold it down so it doesn't move. So far, everything that I printed has turned out good. I get used to doing this more. It's gonna just be like, it would be very easy to do. Now, I don't know what this is wanting to stick to. See, that's perfect there. It's nice. This is kind of for an art project, so I have this masonite, and I'm just going to print on that, but just kind of any way I want to. I'm not going to follow any rules. You can see all the ink that I'm surprised. I thought there would be more ink, and that whole section there didn't have any ink. But that's why I like Silkscreen.
Kind of buried down in my videos. I wrote it a long time ago. I'm gonna stop saying.
I'm just gonna start making a mess now.
Okay. I didn't write it that long ago. It's about a young couple, probably 17, 18 years old, 16, whatever it is, you know.
I'm kind of getting the extra ink off this screen. Now, this will wash up in warm water. It's water resistant or water soluble, and then when it dries, it'd be permanent, and it's for fabric. So it's made for cloth. So real quickly, I'll show it. And it'll take probably half hour before that would dry. So what I made while I was doing this, I don't know what the camera's seeing. I made this. That's kind of... And this one. The green one. The one on textured plastic. One on the old sheet. Oh, I was gonna do one on the weed. I might have time. I don't know. It doesn't matter. This is gonna be the quick version. I have this old weaving that I'm gonna make it on yet. So I'm just showing you this to show that you can see the process of silkscreen.
I have to admit, I'm going to try to read some of the colors now.
So in not very much time, you can print a lot of things, prints, I guess, copies of this on all kinds of things. You're just not limited to t-shirts or,
okay, this is barrel.
Okay. And also, I'm using paper because I've got ink on my hands. If I were doing it properly, I would not have ink on my hands. So this is the last one I'm doing. I put more ink on this. And this is going on a weaving. It's a scarf. And I'm putting it at the bottom. Yes, that looks good. Well, okay. So I don't know. I haven't looked on directions to see how long this takes to dry, but I imagine it takes an hour or so. It'll be on the can. But I just wanted to make a quick video of how to silkscreen and share it with people. Talk to you guys later. Thank you very much. Bye bye. Had a great time doing this.